Hi guys, I'm Roman and this Movavi vlog will bring you some useful YouTube tips. Do you have a YouTube channel and want to promote it? Do you want to get millions of views, likes and subscribers? Then this video is what you need. Today we are talking about end screens, or these clickable icons that appear at the end of the videos. YouTubers also like to call it during the outro. I'll show you how to set your end screens and how they can help with promoting your videos. Let's figure out how it works in detail.
What is an end screen?
End screens are the links on your YouTube video that suggest your viewers watch the next video, subscribe to your or your friend's YouTube channel, or link to your website. Don't underestimate the importance of end screen. They can be a powerful element to help your viewers interact with you. Using end screens, you can guide your viewers around your channel and increase the views for your other videos. I can reveal a secret to you. A watch time session, or how much time a person spends on your channel clicking and watching videos, is one of the most important criteria for channel promotion. This is how YouTube helps people who make interesting videos, not those just looking to gain views with clickbait videos.
Tag specifics.
You can add an end screen to the end of your video that can last from 5 to 20 seconds. In the last 20 seconds, you can add one of these, a link to one of your videos or a playlist, a button to subscribe to your channel, a button to subscribe to your friend's channel, a link to an approved website. If you decide to use a subscription button or website link, I recommend you not only leave it on your screen for 20 seconds, but also ask your viewers to click on these links. To do this, you need to take end screens into account when you write your script and edit your video, so your words in the video are in sync with the appearance of the end screens. The same goes for links to your videos or playlist. You need to leave a place on the screen for them as well, otherwise they will override the image in the video. Let's have a look at a specific example and see what we need to do during shooting and montage so the end screens fit the video.
Think about how your shot will look. Where will your character stand? Leave some place either on the left or on the right, so you can easily place an end screen there. Remember, YouTube lets you put an end screen only in a certain area, in this one. Besides, you can only change the size of your end screen so that it's slightly smaller or bigger. If your outro contains text, place it in the shot so it's easy to read and it leaves some room for an end screen.
Done with the shot arrangement. Great! Let's decide when to insert the end screen. Logically, a viewer needs some time to think and click on the subscription button, the next video, or the link to another site. I recommend you leave at least 5 seconds to give your viewers the opportunity to decide. Don't end the video as soon as you stated your call to action. Many vloggers put bloopers at the end of their videos, not just to entertain viewers, but also to give them time to click on the end screen.
After you upload your video, go to the Video Manager and click the Edit button on your video. Go to the End Screen in Annotation tab. Choose the time when you want to add the end screen on the timeline and click Add Element. You have 4 options to choose from. You can put all 4 in 20 seconds, but I recommend choosing not more than 2. You can place the elements in any highlighted area. That's why I suggested you leave some space during shooting. Now the logo doesn't cover up the character. Change the display time of your end screen so they appear according to your script. You talk about the next video and the end screen with that video appears on the screen. Click Save.
An end screen is a useful tool that can help promote your channel. But don't forget, you also need an interesting topic, quality montage, and other components that make a successful video. Do you use end screens in your videos? Share your experience in the comments. I've given other advice on how to improve your YouTube videos before. Watch for example this tutorial where I'll show you how to make a cool thumbnail for your video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and give us a thumbs up if you like this video. See you soon on the Movavi channel.